Like I said before, it's a pleasure being here in Perak, and we have also seen the delivery by the YBU, compliments of the International Islamic University, and like I mentioned there, our country needs to do a lot for our very poor segment of the population, and we are a population of like 160 million, which I said, and then we have up to like 70 million people living below the poverty line. So it's only like necessary that we come in here and come and borrow some of the strategies of poverty alleviation from Malaysia, since they have done a very good job of it, so that we can carry back to our country and see how we can bring all these people who are so poor out of poverty, so that they too can also begin to enjoy the good life and go to school and eat good food and be healthy. Basically, that's all what we are fighting for. So we have been here before, like Professor said, and at that first trip, we went to Amana Itihad and we learned about microcredit. Today, we are learning about housing for the very poor people. Today, we are learning about food boxes for poor people, such that they can also have the necessary nutrients and be well fed, so that they can think well and carry out their activities in a very, very effective and good manner. Basically, that is the reason why we are here, and we intend to continue to have this collaboration, and these exchange programs are going to continue. And as we get the programs, we hope and pray that we too will be able to learn and replicate them in our country, so that our people can also benefit from the experience of YBU and other experiences in Malaysia. About 30% of our population of youth are unemployed, and so we are also going to like take a look at the volunteer corps and see how we can also replicate that and have lots of youth who are not doing anything and have passed through school get some things doing. We can give them microcredit, like we saw, where somebody can maybe repair motorcycles or get a grocery store, and you just get them some funds so that they can be on their own and also become employers of labor instead of everybody waiting for government to give them a job. The jobs are no longer there, so people can now be on their own. And then once we have some of these trades, like we have seen YBU is doing for their people and the youth, we can also copy that and see how we can also help our youthful population. Yes, like I told you, the government has a transformation agenda, the present government, and we are all running towards poverty alleviation. About a month ago, the government brought in about 200 billion Nigerian naira for microcredit for the vulnerable and poor groups. And then, so we have lots of programs on ground, but we are also trying to learn and then know the systems as well, because it's just not the programs alone, the targeting mechanisms, the payment procedures, you know, because such that if, for instance, we are paying through the commercial banks now, maybe we can now think of paying through microfinance banks. You know, these are the issues, and then the targeting. How are you targeting your own poor people? Because, like I mentioned when I was talking just now, you have a situation where somebody who is not even poor tries to enter so he can also get some of the benefits. So if we learn how Malaysia is able to do it, then we can also copy. So these are the issues. Then the issues of corruption. For instance, if this microcredit is for very poor people, but some of the officials who have been given the mandate to administer the program can now bring in their children and their so a lot of people who are not supposed to be included in the program now get included. So, but if we know the systems Malaysia has used to reduce those inclusion exclusion errors, then we can also be able to now come up with our programs that will be foolproof and tight, so that if you try to smuggle yourself in, we'll push you out, because we know we've got some experience from Malaysia. Basically, that's what we're saying.